Hey guys, what's up? It's Lena here with another review for Casey Undercover. And this review, this episode was basically, it's like a watchdog episode, and it's kind of like a Casey and Craig's episode, where Craig feel like it's a competition between him and Casey. So let's get into it. Casey and Craig here, they neighbor Mrs. Goldberry, I think that's her name, Mrs. Goldberry, screaming really loud. She got like an annoying thing. I was like, that's like her little trademark. She got annoying loud scream, and so they hear her, and she run in with her son, and she's like, my house has been robbed, and she want to take action because she's saying the police isn't doing anything. So Casey's like, why don't we start a watch group, you know, like a neighborhood watch group, and Craig can be the leader and stuff. And so Craig really want everything to be like safe, play it safe, you know, like don't go and run around and like be taking action and stuff. So then Casey's like, yeah, he'll be a great leader. And so then Mrs. Goldberg was like, okay, well, bring snacks too. So then Craig was like, now I gotta feed the whole neighborhood. Then Casey's like, dad, nobody want to fight crime on an empty stomach. Theme song time. They got everybody at their house, all the neighbors at the house for the watchdog group. And then Ernie tries to sweet talk, I guess, with this girl. He calls himself the E-Man. He said the E-Man's gonna protect you from all the crime and stuff. And then the girl ended up elbowing him. And then Casey was like, now who's gonna protect the E-Man? Chris is there, and Casey is saying hello to all of their neighborhood, neighbors or whatever. And they the Melberry Lane watchdogs, and Craig is the watch leader. Craig said that he has spoken to the authorities and everything is cool, and he wants all the neighbors to stay in their house, get a motion sensor light, and then just wait to see what happens. But then their neighbor Herb, which is an actor, he's always in a lot of stuff. He was in a lot of Disney stuff, and he was in a lot of other stuff. But I'm gonna just put his name right there. Y'all should go look it up. But anyway, his name is Herb, and he's saying, don't we need to get our pepper spray and our weapons and stuff? And Craig is like, no, we don't need weapons. We don't need to take action. We just gotta stay in the house and watch. And everybody wants to take action and fight, but Craig just wants them to stay at home. And Casey thought of everybody watching the blocks and patrolling the area and everybody taking turns and stuff, but Craig really don't like it. Judy got a friend at school. His name is Slippy, and he likes her a lot, and she don't like him, but he's in love with her. Casey was trying to rush Craig out of the house. Then Casey calls out the rest of the watchdogs, and she did like a call. She's like, woo, 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 woo. And then they all came out. Then Casey's a new group leader, and she was saying, we all gonna take action, and we're gonna do this because Craig, but make sure my dad don't know. And Marissa was like trying to tell her that Craig came back in the house and was right behind her, but Casey obviously wasn't listening. And then Craig was like, if you're gonna be the watch leader, know when somebody's watching you. And so he's pretty upset. So Casey said, it's not what it looks like. And he was like, oh, really? It's not like you just took over the watch group. And she's like, okay, it resembles what it looks like. And he said, y'all really want a 16-year-old leading you? And Casey like, it ain't a competition. Mrs. Goldberry says, who's in favor of Craig? Then it was like, nobody went and put their hands. And it's like, who's in favor of Casey? The neighbor was like, in favor. And she was like, Craig, do you need a calculator to calculate all those favors or no? Because nobody put their hands up. He's back in class, and this boy named Slippy is still in love with her, and she tries to tell him things that will make him not love her no more, but he said we perfect for each other, and he still loves her. So now she got to think of another plan to get rid of him. Casey was eating, and at the table, she's like, dad, can I have the butter? And he's like, can I pass you the butter? Am I good enough to pass you the butter? And then she was like, I'm starting to think it's not about I'm not about the butter no more. So then Casey's like, I only disobey you because I don't agree with you. Then Craig thinks that since he is an adult, she should always listen to him because she's only a child and he's an adult. And he's always right. Somebody in all black was at Miss Goldberry's house, and she think he's a robber. So Miss Goldberry come out, she beats him up, and then she was for the rest of the neighborhood watch, and it was Craig in that thing. So she just beat up Craig. And then Casey was like, what are you doing? And Craig was trying to teach Casey a lesson that teaching other people to fight isn't good because, you know, it's in that you can't just put, like, fighting stuff in people's hands. So Craig's going to start up his own neighborhood watch group so he can see which one is better, Casey or his. Craig starts his own neighborhood watch group. It's Ernie and the other neighbor, Herb. And Casey and her group is downstairs chatting their name loud. So Herb is trying to think of a cool name, so they come to be the Lucky Lose watch group. Craig didn't approve of that. He don't like it. Ernie love it though. So Craig is trying to figure out a plan, and Craig is just trying to be better than Casey's group. He's not even trying to watch the neighborhood no more. He's trying to be better. He's trying to tell Slippy that somebody else already has her heart, and Slippy's like, "We both love each other." And she's like, she said, "I already got a boo, and that boo ain't you." And then he's like, "Okay, whatever." So then the person that's pretending to be a boyfriend is Miss Goldberry's son, and then he comes in to pretend to be the boyfriend, but then he messes up, and then the boy don't believe him. Casey is talking to the group, and she's like, "Craig keeps teaching me like a kid." And Miss Gilroy's like, "You're 10 times the man your father will ever be." And then she's like, "I don't know if you're trying to boost my confidence or are you trying to make me cry." Marissa ordered a pizza just to get a delivery guy her number. Marissa, she said the pizza just came with it. So Craig and they was staking Casey and them was staking out in the bushes. So then Craig and his group, Herb and Ernie, was staking out too in the backyard or somewhere, trying to catch the thief before Casey group does, so he can be better than her. So Herb said he has to pee, and Craig is like, "Go to my house and let yourself in." And Ernie's like, "I don't know why he doesn't just go pee in the bushes like everybody else do." And then Craig is like, "Oh, Ernie," because they was sitting in the grass where Ernie most likely peed at. Casey's group sees somebody taking stuff out of the house, and they go run over there. And then Craig and Ernie sees them too, and they go run over there. So Casey starts beating up the guy. She's like, "Give you a little this." And then they saw. Then Craig get there, and they start fighting over the guy. Like, "No, he's mine. No, he's my criminal," and all that tug of war to the guy. So the guy was just taking out his trash. He wasn't stealing anything. So Casey's like, "You can have him, Dad." Then Marissa's like, "Oh, you got new hair and lost weight," because it was today. They new na their neighbor stops, and the cops are at Casey's house. Ooh, so he gets there, and the cops are taking out the robber. And it was like the cops said that somebody else saw that they motion light was going off, and they saw something suspicious. So they take the thing off the robber, and it's Herb, and he was stealing from them. So Miss Gorby's like, "Great job, Craig. You let a robber in the watch group and had him break into your house." Then Ernie's like, "No, he didn't break into it. Dad gave him the keys." Then Craig's like, "Thanks, Ernie, for telling her that." So then Casey's like, "I'm sorry, your whole plan was completely right. I should have listened to you. You're the adult. If we would just all stayed inside, then we would have caught him." Apologizes too, and he said he shouldn't be trying to compete with her and all that. Then Casey was like, "Yeah, you are. You want to know what? I wonder where I get from myself being a good leader from." It's like, oh, sweet moment. Kira was absent this episode. But Ken Casey's like, since we know our neighbors more, we should do a book club. Ernie's like, "Yeah, we could be the bookie lose." And Craig is like, "Give it up, Ernie, Jesus." And he's like, "What? It's catching." Gorbea's son is buying Judy Froyo, and he loves her. And she's like, "You can stop pretending to be my boyfriend." He said, "Who's pretending?" Then he was like, "I love you. You just like my mom." And Judy's mad, so she's like, "Well, now that I know how you feel about me, I'm gonna show you how I feel about you." And then, so she said, "My friends, Pentatonix." We saw Pentatonix at the Billboard Music Awards. It's on our vlog. We saw him going in. If you go, I'm gonna put the link right here in the box inside me. But we saw Pentatonix. Yay! Anyway, so Pentatonix, she had them sing Ariana Grande Problem, and it was so cool. They was on the beatboxing and stuff. Oh my god, the guy was singing. They was all singing and stuff, and it was so freaking cool. So when it was done, the kid was like, "I can't believe you got them from me. You must really like me." So Judy was like, "Oh my god," and Pentatonix was like, "Oh my god." Now Pentatonix was just so freaking cool. It was so cool that they had them on it. I thought they was gonna be on it a little bit more, but it was still cool that they was on it at the end, cause I love them and they so cool. So that was the end of the show, guys. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it makes sense to watch it because it's good, because I'm doing like a review on it. But anyway, thanks for watching it. Like, share, subscribe, and comment to this video. Since I know, send everybody from the Kissing and the Comcast and this box right here on the side of me. The cast Twitter is going to be down below in the description. So is on my social media. So follow me on all of that. And I will see you guys next week for another Kissing and the Cover review. And congratulations to Zendaya, she just graduated high school like the other day, and she graduated, and so did Camille McFadden, he graduated too. So congratulations to everybody that's graduating, and bye.